After understanding the history and need for banking technology, now we understand the payment systems in the electronic banking, payment systems and electronic banking, how they're related and in what way the banking system has undergone changes with respect to payment system also. The growth of technology has changed payment system to across the world in a great way, and it's in the last two to three decades the changes have been going on, and a lot of innovations have taken place with more innovative thoughts, more innovative way of payments in the through banking channels, replacing the cash bank, cash and coin, etc., and also bank notes have been introduced, etc. The principal method of payment before the introduction of the bank paper, that is a check or credit transfers, the now they become a part of a payment system with popularity of banking with electronic modes, different electronic modes and other channels. The major routine process of day-to-day banking is involvement of payment in the payments in the payment. Is the cash counter or a teller counter, teller counters in the banks. Essentially, the idea behind electronic payment system is that a number of activities related to payment should be done with the help of a computer. That is the with the prime idea, with the prime motive objective of that, the time reduction in the electronic payment, in the payment, and also management of the electronic system, electronic media, use of technology in the payment system. The modes of payments are they are basically compliant with the BIS bankers settlement core principles, international bank settlement core principles, and clearinghouse corporation, CCIL, corporation rules, and RTGS norms, CFMS, PDO, NDS, SSR, SSI, PK enabled securities, SFMS, Infinite, and IDRBT, or the channels, other regulators, etc. So these are the new things that have come to enable payments like continuous link settlements, centralized central counterparty settlements, secure netting systems like netting systems like NEFT, etc., payment of versus payment like real-time gross settlements, RTGS, electronic dealing settlement platforms like DMAT and the trade platforms, delivery versus payments, and dematerialization of securities, etc., are the different modes of payment settlement that involve in the technology. We look into how each of the technology helps the customer in improving his service levels or perform his needs, how his needs are met in the process, and what are the regulations that govern in, and what are the security features available in the within these payment systems. Let us go through them. The electronic payment system, the first one is the ATM. ATM, when we talk ATM, it's a short form, automated teller machine. Automated teller machine is an electronic device that initially used for dispensing the cash. It was an offline mode. Based on some telecom connection, the electronic machine, telecommunication device that enabled clients to clients of the financial institution to perform a financial transaction without the need of the cashier or a human clerk or a human intervention or the bank teller. Bank teller earlier used to be a physical person, counter that enabled a quicker dispensing of the cash within the bank premises. Now ATM. When we take a reference of the ATM here, it's an automated teller machine which doesn't require a manual intervention in the system. ATMs are known by various names by banks, and banks have their own choice of putting it, like Freedom, like 24/7, cash in, cash out, like that. Many names are there with ATMs, which is a customary to each of the banks. Okay. Most modern ATMs are customer-centric, customer identified by inserting the plastic card. The modus is you are issued a card, which is used as token, which is used within the AD machine, which is inserted in the into the AD machine, which verifies internally. Let us see the what the verification can make. Let us examine that a little later and understand the concept first. The ATM plastic card inserted, that ATM works out internally and then dispenses cash if you are eligible to receive the cash. Otherwise, it will throw an error and then puts back the card into your. The ATMs are magnetic stripe or plastic smart card or chip based contains. Now RBI has mandated all plastic cards with the magnetic strip or any other strips should be with a replaced with a chip based smart card. Chip based is to ensure that it's a fraud proof, it's a more secure way of using the card, etc. Those are the lot of security features have been built into that as per the RBI guidelines to all bankers who issue or encourage use of plastic cards or smart cards. Okay. Using an ATM, customer can access their bank account in order to make their cash withdrawals or make their balance inquiry or take a mini statement or deposit a check or deposit a cash or make pre-selected utility bills payment also. It is possible with ATMs now. These are the new initiatives that have been taking place with the ATM. ATM, when we talk about ATM, we'll have to, because it's most popularly used machine that's deployed across city or across multiple locations of a particular bank. The main features, main components of the machine are, ATM machine are CPU. CPU is central processing unit. And magnetic strip card reader. There's a reader within the card slot which reads the data on the presented on the card. Pin pad is a key in pad that helps you to insert the secret code of the card into the system. And secure crypto processor. In the system, there's a crypto processor is there which converts the entire pin data and your requirements, etc. There are a set of various functions that have been performed by that, or securely encrypted. Encryption, crypto is encryption of the data into an unreadable format. Okay, then there is a display. Display is what is your request made, how the system understood that request and it displays that. And function key to or a touch screen. Now the earlier ATMs used to be a key based systems, now more advanced, now touch based now. They are into screen touch screens based, whereby you can input the system your requirements into a touch screen type of thing. And record printer, and there's a printer that generates output for you with the amount of transaction done or with the amount of the nature of transaction done, location of the ATM, and brief details of the account holder or account details, and then station number, etc. Some details, static details are there as mandated by RBI. These details are printed in the general. And there's a vault which holds the cash within the ATM. And this housing which connects the system into the base or the form location. These are the basic components of the ATM. ATM usage delivery channel is regulated by NCPA, National Council of Payment of India, IDRBT. IDRBT is a main promoter of the banking channel and then of the RBI wing, and RBI itself is another regulator. And the last applicable to this delivery channels are Payment Settlement Act and IT Act 2000 as amended as on 2008. These are the few things. And what is the advantage we have? The convenience is we have 24/7 access to the ATM system. And less time for the transaction, instead of going to the bank or branch or business unit and present yourself for the payment, and then submit a check or a token or something for in lieu of the payment, and then all these are avoided by this less time for the transaction, privacy of transaction. You can do it in a private, within your knowledge, and then branch or bank enabled, any branch can be, any branch ATM can be used now across the banks, and acceptability across multiple bank ATMs. The advantage is with the technology, of course there are regulations attached associated with that. The technology permits the ATM card of one bank can be used at another bank's ATM for withdrawal of cash or making inquiry into your account, depending on the facility that has been provided with the bank's ATM. These are the few advantages. And other modes of electronic payments include the electronic magnetic card, the credit, which are credit cards, charge cards, debit cards, smart card or chip cards. These are one form or other the cards in family. Credit card, of course, many of us are familiar with the credit card system. The credit card is a credit limit is fixed on the card system, card of the user of the card, and the it's a revolving credit, and the amount spent on the card will be charged at the end of the month or at the end of the cycle, whatever cycle is being chosen there. And the credit card holder has to pay the amount on the end of the cycle. Similarly, charge cards are, there's a mechanism in the credit card itself, there's a mechanism. The charge can be on a base of a monthly basis or on the base of as and when it happens. That's a type of card. And debit cards again are the, which do not have any credit limit on that, but then associated with your SB account, savings bank account, or any other account, deposit account, where the card is issued, and then you can swipe the card as long as balance is available in the account. And smart or chip card are new form of cards that been mandated by RBI to replace the old magnetic cards, which are more prone for fraud and other misuse of the card by the fraudsters, to avoid those risks in the card system, the smart cards or chip cards have been introduced. When we look at the ATM system, there are some more features available with the ATM system that are ATMs. There are ATMs with cash dispensers only, that is called CDs, cash dispensers only, which are lower version of the ATMs now. Which only can do cash dispensation, and they are no longer in use. They are very few in use now, because most of the banks opted for more higher version of ATMs, which can deliver more service, etc., more services to the customer. And networking of ATM is another feature that been taking place into the ATM area. There are future prospectus of ATMs is increasing the number of transactions per ATM and per day. These are the optimistic view of the many of the bankers, and establishing connectivity with the point of sales, that's called shortly called POS terminals of the merchant establishments. Now we see a lot of changes in the technology. With the use of debit card, we can go to a merchant and then buy our merchandise or products using debit card. Earlier this was not feasible. With the technology initiatives, this was made possible, and ATMs, like ATMs, POS also connected to the merchant establishments for the withdrawal of, for either doing a transaction or buying a goods, etc. Similarly, e-ticketing, sorry, utilities like e-ticketing, bills payment, etc. are possible now. Providing international payment gateways like Visa and MasterCard, etc., is also these also made possible now. The HWAK is a intelligent ATM that being considered for installation. Intelligent auto teller system, which is a special breed of ATM, which capable of thinking and thinking themselves, and that means the faster way of imposing the impose less demands on the banking operations, banking system, and serve the customers more like a personal banker than sophisticated teller machine. The advantages are customer satisfaction. This machine is called HWAK, is a abbreviated word. for the intelligent auto teller network management system. Okay, the advantage you have is customer satisfaction, high availability, online offline availability, auto recovery, anytime full banking facilities, low cost, shorter intervals, shorter queues, and quick and early implementation, etc. And network management is easy. Enhanced security. Security also is more built into that, like video cameras, etc. and all available there. And then predicted and comprehensive one-stop store. It's a comprehensive one-stop store in the sense you can access many of the services, utilities there. Now coming to credit cards. Credit cards, as we already said, it's a credit facility granted by issuing bank to the customer based on his other KYC norms and other parameters required for the customer to comply with. This facility is granted and this as a revolving on a revolving basis. The facility is used as long as used is in it's been the bills are charged once in a month or as per the cycle, bill cycling, and the customer has to pay the bills on due date and meet the, and liquidate the outstandings as of that time. And the credit card is different from charge card. Is charge card is requires the balance to be paid into the in the full month, and in contrast, credit card allows the customers to continue the balances of debt subject to the interest being charged on a periodical basis. A credit card differs from a charge card also. In other, credit card typically involves a third party entity that is based the smaller, that the seller and is the reimbursed by the buyer. Whereas the charge card is simply differs in payment of the buyer to the later date. Okay. These are the few changes in the, few advancements in the technology, and the other modes of electronic payments are there. Like example, electronic purse is there, which is worldwide used but not come into India so popularly. It is a cash in electronic form that a form can be securely used. But in India, its use is very limited, and still India has to catch up on that. And electronic check can be used during the funds transfer like EFT, POS, etc. And electronic cash. Do not confuse between the electronic purse and the cash. Cash this can be loaded into a card for use. Like you know, typically, State Bank of India uses a foreign travel card. Similarly, there are other banks which use similar cards, which are cash built into the card. And then when you go to the market, you can use it as a cash. And it's a secure to use also. And electronic banking, there are other channels also available in the electronic banking. When we say electronic banking, the word means a facility given to the customer where he did not go to the bank premises and present himself physically. He can do it online or he can do it on a telephone on like anytime bank, corporate or personal banking, or such services are available available on a telephone, mobile banking or internet banking or ATM, any of the channels. Or telebanking, which is a call center concept kind of banking. Okay, the in the electronic payment system, there are two methods of updating the data, payment system, payment data. The update facilities are batch mode or online mode. Online mode is used when it is a immediate settlement, online, real-time settlement, like RTGS. You strike a transaction here within no time, the other end it will be received. And the account will be accordingly debited or credited with the funds. Similarly, forex transactions can wait for no time. Similarly, there are other modes. ATM transaction, it should be online. It cannot be in batch mode. Okay, the customer account should reflect a correct true picture of the debit or credit or deposit or withdrawal of the cash. Similarly, batch mode are also used in updating the data. Batch mode, when it is used, when you have a bulk of payments, bulk of credits to be uploaded, like example, dividend warrant payments, or pension payments, or a salary payment, where the bank takes time to upload all the files before a due date. So these are the two modes of update facilities. And the other delivery channels include internet banking, mobile banking, telebanking, etc. The other technology in use are, now these are the delivery channels. Sorry. With the introduction of technology, the clearinghouse also underwent a lot of changes with regard to check presentment and payment. The check truncation has been initiated Delhi with a few banks, and it has been replicated to most of the metros and other cities also where this facility is in place. In this check truncation, let us understand what is check truncation. Check truncation is a mechanism in which a check's image is truncated into a digital image and then forwarded to the bank where the payment has to be effected. The check can be retained by the bank or the clearinghouse which is holding the check. It can hold the check and then the physical check, and the image that goes there, the paying banker, he will honor the check if it is in order and then pay it as if it is a physical check to him. See, in this connection, NI Act is amended suitably, and which reads like NI Act section 6B of the NI Act talks about check which is truncated during the course of a clearing cycle, either by a clearinghouse or by a bank, whether paying or receiving the payment immediately on generation of the, this is the highlight, on generation of the digital image, the electronic image of transmission, substituting the physical check for the physical presentment of the check or movement of the check to in writing. So that indicates that a check can be made payable to, a check image can be made payable to the other at the other bank, but the limitations are it is a electronic image in lieu of the paper check, it is a transaction will substitute the physical check for presentation, the truncation is done during the clearing operations only, and it's only meant for clearing operations, and it can be done by a clearinghouse or a bank holding the check, and paper checks after truncation to be kept with the generation check, truncation generated bank or branch or clearinghouse. Additional digital signature can be associated or attached to the check format. The additional feature in the check truncation is given option as a option is given to the banker who made the truncation at his end. It is optional to affix a digital signature, which is another security feature which cannot be repudiated in a later point of time. The other technical advancements are in the field of technology, note and coin counting machines, microfiche or microfilm. It's a relatively voluminous data can be retained in that. It's a storehouse, but then there has to be certain controls on the data to be protected from the tampering or from the misuse of the data. These we will discuss when we come to a consideration, the security considerations of the technology. Thank you very much.